Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 14 Beta 4 has been out a little while to developers and public beta testers, and so I wanted to talk about more new features that I didn't cover in my initial video. Now, quite a few of you sent me videos or sent me photos of things that you were having either issues with or new features you found. So thanks to everyone that sent those along. I'm just going to cover the new features right now. And the first thing is 4K YouTube videos. If you weren't aware, iOS 14 supports VP9. It's a codec that YouTube uses. And of course, many of you have had this with previous betas, but it finally showed up for me. And so you'll see that I have it here on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. It may vary on device to device, but you should be able to do up to 2160p or 4K in HDR. So it's great to have that feature. Now, a viewer Subash pointed out that if you put this in landscape and pull down the control center, the volume sliders are now taking up the full height of the display. So in this landscape orientation, you can see volume and display brightness are now full size widgets instead of just sort of being a smaller area. So it's something you'll see only in landscape though. So you have to be in a video, then pull down that way. You'll be able to see it that way. Now, if you use the Apple Store app, there's actually a hidden Easter egg. So go into the Apple Store app, wait for it to load, go to search and type in 10 years. And it will pop up some balloons celebrating 10 years of the Apple Store. So you can sort of interact with them, move them around, and it's just celebrating that 10-year anniversary. Now there's another change with widgets on the home screen. So if you press and hold to edit the widget, and then you go to edit, you'll see it looks a little bit different than we had with Beta 3. So I'll do the same on my iPhone XR that's running Beta 3, and you'll see it just looks a little bit different. So it's a little bit larger, has more room, and they've changed some of the colors and things as well. Also, they've made it better correlate with the background, so it's a little bit nicer that way. Now, they've also changed the flag color within email. So if we go into an email, now within email, if you swipe over and maybe you want to flag the email, you'll see that it's now red. They keep changing this color, and I'm not sure what they'll settle on finally, but that's what it currently is. Also, if we go into this email and then we flag it, maybe we'll flag it as green, and then we go back and we go to flag, you'll see that it's now green. So I'm not sure there's a default color. I think it's based on what you actually set. Now within music, they've made a few changes as well. So if we go into the music app, I have beta 3 on the left, beta 4 on the right again. You'll see at the top, the add button has been updated. So it's changed again, similar to what we have with the play and shuffle buttons, but now it's a gray background with reddish text with a plus and then the word add. If we add this, we'll hit add. We'll give it just a moment. It'll download here. Now, once it's downloaded, you'll see up here that there's a check mark instead of the word downloaded next to a check mark. So beta 4 updates it a little bit and cleans it up. Of course, Apple could change this again at any time. Now, once you're in music and playing it, you have an option for infinity, or basically what this means is it will continue playing after the song ends. So maybe you only picked one song and you want to continue playing songs like it afterward, tap on the infinity symbol. Now this has been here for a couple betas, but I didn't point it out in previous ones. And this was actually sent over by a viewer named, I'm not sure I'm going to say this right, but Cylindocool. I'm not sure if I said that, so I apologize if I didn't say it right, but he sent that over and said that this symbol was there. I hadn't seen it before, so it's something that's new. Also, some people are getting a new splash screen when they go to actually share an album or share any of these different songs. So I'm not seeing that. It just brings up my share sheet, but when some people share it, it brings up a new little splash screen. Now there's also a couple new splash screens the first time you go into different applications. And the first one has to do with reminders. The first time you go into reminders, it gives you a new splash screen that says what's new in reminders, assign reminders, smart suggestions, and lots more. So that's one that's new. And then also there's a new splash screen for notes. And when you open it for the first time, it might take a moment. It pops up and says, welcome to notes, add almost anything, note to self or with anyone. And then also it says, sketch your thoughts. Now I had quite a few problems with this and other people told me they had this issue as well. And the first person to point this out was DX Clan tweets that there was a new splash screen. I went into notes like I normally do and I couldn't hit continue because my keyboard kept popping up. Now, if this happens to you, go into your multitasking, close the app, try it over again, hit continue. It works for me, no problem. So it just depends on the device. I had a lot of issues with my 11 Pro Max with that. Now there's an additional pop-up when deleting an app. I didn't see this before. I saw a slight change before. I'll show you. If I go over to, let's say, YouTube, and we press and hold to delete it, and then we tap on remove app, you'll see on the old one, it says remove from home screen. On the new one, it says move to library. I showed that before, but if I tap delete app on the newer version, it says, are you sure you want to delete it? Or basically, deleting this app will also delete its data. So I want to cancel that. If I hit delete on beta 3, it will just delete the app right away. So that's a little bit of a change and newer. Now there's a couple small changes in the news app. Prod by Legend sent one of them over. And the first one is, if we go into news, we'll wait for it to load here. And at the top, you'll see we now have two buttons. One says audio, catch up on the news, and listen to Apple News Plus stories on the go. And then the one to the right says local news. And it says now in New York, Houston, Los Angeles, and the Bay Area. We knew this was coming, but now they have dedicated sections at the top. And then as you scroll down, you'll get your audio briefing now as well. So that's showing up in news. Now the final change was sent over by Noah Messer. So I appreciate everyone that sent those over. And it has to do with on the lock screen when you go to swipe up. So if we turn off the phone, turn them back on, wait for it to wake up. And at the bottom, you'll see it says swipe to open. It's slightly smaller on beta 4. So I'm not sure you can see that there, but it's ever so slightly smaller. So those are all the changes I missed in the initial video with iOS 14 beta 4. And of course, there's probably small changes throughout with fonts and things like that. Apple will continually change and tweak this to get it right by the time it launches sometime in late September or October. Now look for beta 5 either this week or based on previous releases, probably it's going to be on a 2-week cycle until after beta 5. So we may not see anything this coming week. It may be another week, but you never know what Apple's going to do. But based on what they've done in the past, it'll be another week until we see beta 5. But if you found anything else or anything else you'd like to share, let me know in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.